Hey, what's up everyone? Red Zone Gaming here, and today I'm going to teach you how to make the perfect AI for your game. Well, this is more top-down AI. Anyway, so the first thing you want to start off with is your basic sprites and your player object and your enemy object. So first, go ahead and create a collision event with the enemy. Now, we're going to go ahead and create a var list. We're going to have an X offset, a Y offset, and just a random variable there. So, I'm going to do... Here, wait. 1 second. Now it should be easier for you guys to see the code. Okay. So after those variables are created, go ahead and create, put A is equal to point direction. We're going to do X, Y, other dot X, other dot Y. And it's set the X offset equal to length direction X. Do 5 and A. Now set the Y offset equal to length direction Y 5 and A. Now we're gonna create a while loop. Put, I don't know if I can type today. While place meeting. Basically, this is going to state while we're colliding with the object, we're going to move outside of the object. And we're going to move the other object outside of us. Okay, so that should be the collision event with, if we collide with another instance of enemy. Basically, this is a fix so that the enemies do not clump. So, for instance, if I put the enemy in the room with this collision event, and I put another enemy right on top of it, they should move outside of each other if we did this correctly. There you go. Okay, now we have to make them try to follow the player. To do that, we're going to make them pathfinding so they can find their way around objects. So I'm going to go ahead and create a sprite here really quickly. It's going to be a wall. Alright, so go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and make my wall gray. Should have a decent collision mask, center it. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and create that wall object. Object wall. And this is going to be what our enemy is going to try to avoid while going towards the player. So I'm going to go ahead and create a step event and a create event. In the create event, we're going to instance a few variables like speed, and this is where we're going to start our pathfinding. Okay. First thing we're going to do is create a grid. Since a grid is equal to mp underscore grid underscore create, the grid's going to be from 0, 0. And it's going to have cells that are 32 by 32. And then that's the grid. So we're going to go ahead and create add a path to the grid. This path is going to be what the object is going to avoid and the object's target. mp grid underscore add instances to our path. Going to add our wall. It's going to have one. That should be the start of our pathfinding, and I'll come back when I'm in the step event. Okay, so now in the step event of the enemy, start by putting mp underscore grid underscore path. Do grid path xy target.x target.y and our speed. So these targets, I'm gonna define these in the create event. Basically, this is an easy way of setting the enemy to follow multiple objects. Like, let's say that there are that you have some AI in the game helping you out. If you're making a top-down shooter and you want the enemy to attack the closest AI, or the closest, or if you're closer than the AI, then you want the enemy to attack you. This is where you could use that target variable. So I'll be right back when I'm in the create event. Okay, so we're going to set the target equal to our player. Okay, now back in the step event, going to put path start, path, speed, or... yeah, speed, and just leave that blank, then put 1 for the absolute. So I'll be right back when the game is up, and yeah, just go ahead and test your game. Make sure you spell everything right. There we go. Now, the enemy landed right on top of my player. So we're going to make it so that the enemy cannot go right on top of the player. So in the step event of, actually it's easier to do this in its own separate event. Right. In a collision event with the player, going to simply have x equals x previous. You could use the same collision code that you had for the enemy, but this is easier, and you really only need to use that code if you're colliding into another moving object. So I'm going to go ahead and maximize the view here with and we're going to put some walls around the enemy and see if it finds its way around the walls to the player. There are two players in the room for some reason. Alright, it went around the wall and boom. So, we're going to put multiple AI around to try to find their way to the player. We're going to put some on top of each other to see if they split apart. So it's a little bit buggy. You may have to do the same thing for the collision with the player, because another moving object can be pushed into the player. So if you really want your enemy to stay where it's supposed to be, go ahead and just copy paste the same code into the collision event with the player. But it may cause the player to move as well. Probably will. Yes, it will. So that could be a nice effect if you like it or not. They kind of jitter around too much for me, so change. If you don't like the weird jittering around, go ahead and change that to 1. And if you don't like them moving the player around, you can just comment these out right here. I think it gives a nice effect, allowing them to push the player around. There you go.